This is the new Insta360 Pro 2 camera.
Cinema 5D at Photokina 2018 is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. Cartoni supports your vision. Canon, live for the story. And CVP, your one-stop shop for cine, video, photo, and more.
Hi, this is Nino from Cinema 5D. We're here at Photokina 2018 at Insta360 with Max. Hi, Max, how are you?
Hey, Nino, how's it going?
Very well. You recently announced the successor to the Insta360 Pro camera,
right.
The Insta360 Pro 2.
Right.
So what are the biggest differences between the two?
So the Pro 2 camera is our new flagship professional camera. It can shoot 8K at 3D, so that's a big upgrade. Previous Pro was only 6K. So that's a good news for all professional filmmakers, and especially filmmakers who produce virtual reality content. They now have better 3D content available at an attractive price point. But then also we upgraded the frame rates to 8K 60 frames per second. And then we have some more advancements that are more looking at the workflow in general. Like we have now a Farside video downlink system that is basically replacing the previous Wi-Fi connections for a much more stable and high quality preview picture. And then also we work with Adobe on the post-production workflow-wise on a plugin that you can do no-stitch editing.
So first of all, you mentioned it's now higher resolution.
Right.
When talking about normal cinema cameras, you know, 16:9 kind of shooting or DCI
right.
70:9 shooting, 8K is still kind of considered
right.
hype, you
right.
know, like it's not like you can really display it. It's
right.
sometimes used to crop in. But why, maybe you can explain to the viewers who are not as experienced with 360 content,
right.
Why 8K is important for VR content.
So 8K is important because 8K is only referring to the whole spherical image. That means that 360, the whole 360 sphere is actually 8K. So if you crop it down in a traditional video, or if you watch that on a headset, then what you actually see per eye is only 4K. So that's quite important to know. With
if at all, I mean, is that the maximum?
Yeah. Right, like on a standard headset, it can be even lower. But that's why it's important that you have high resolution, high intensity of pixels to show good quality VR content. And that's why actually resolution really matters for 360.
Yeah. Yeah. You mentioned the improved image transmission. I'm a customer of the original Insta360 Pro, and while I like it a lot, one of the problems I had is that it loses the Wi-Fi connection very easily. And you don't have a preview image anymore. And I've had this problem every now and then. So how are you transmitting images now? And how big is the latency and how far can you go?
Right, so the new system is called Insta360 Farside. That's a proprietary system from our side that we exclusively developed for the Pro line. And how this works is basically similar to DJI Lightbridge, what you know from the drone industry. It's a video transmission signal up to 2 kilometers ground to air. Ground to ground, it's around 200, 300 meters. And that is really important. Like, imagine you're a VR filmmaker, you don't want to be in the image. So you can go to another room, or if you mount it on a drone, you can control it from the ground. And that's like super interesting for filmmakers in general, and will make the whole workflow much easier.
And that whole, I mean, we saw that the system is it's like a separate box that you have
right.
to attach
right.
to the Insta360 Pro 2 via Ethernet.
Exactly.
Is it part of the kit?
It's part of the kit, it's part of the bundle, and yes, you said you connected via Ethernet cable. You have a receiver, you have a sender. The receiver is connected with a smartphone, with an iPad, Android phone, and then you control it via our Insta360 Pro app, and you get all the settings, all the previews. You now can even like use that signal and connect Farside with your laptop and further stream it or broadcast it to another platform.
Is there, apart from the resolution with the new version, is there any change in picture quality? Do you use bigger sensors?
Right.
Is it the same?
We have another sensor, bigger sensor, so also improved low light conditions. Welcome to check out the sample footage on our website. But then also, like, what is pretty new is that now we have a 9-axis gyroscope built in. And that will give you really smooth electronic image stabilization. We call it flow state. In my opinion, it's gimbal-like. You don't need a gimbal anymore. Also, when mounting it on a drone, there's really some impressive stuff. That's also super important for VR content in general. You don't want that shaky footage in a headset. You will get headaches. So stabilization very important for 360, and we think we did a good job with the flow state technology.
You mentioned that the post-production 360 of 360 content is sometimes a bit of a pain with some software. So what did you do with Adobe, what you mentioned, to enhance that?
So we partnered up with Adobe and developed a new plugin. It's a Insta360 No Stitch plugin. And as the name mentions, it's like basically importing raw, unstitched footage directly in Adobe Premiere and treat this like traditional flat video. So filmmakers who maybe have nothing to do with 360, it's very easy to enter that market and get used to it. It's basically like working with traditional video. Once you finish with editing, once you finish with post-production, you export everything and then you only stitch those files and those scenes that you actually need in the final file. So it's like improving the workflow, but also improves time efficiency.
Okay. Yeah. Anything else you want to add in terms of new features?
Right. We also introduced a new crystal cube layer. So that's actually our solution on how to play back 8K content, because with current headsets you're like limited to 4K or Oculus Go, maybe even lower. With crystal cube technology you're able to play back 8K, and we use a dynamic rendering, so you actually only renders 8K resolution where you look at. So if I look on that side, it will dynamically render to 8K.
And so that's a player for Windows and Mac.
That is fully available for Oculus Go, for Samsung Gear, Apple, Windows, Mac. That's available for free from our website. You're even welcome to check out the SDK if you have your own player. Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool for like actually distributing 8K content, because it was also a bottleneck that we saw.
Yeah. Great. What about pricing and availability of the Insta360 Pro 2?
Right, it's $5,000 $4,999, available worldwide. Select retailers, be in Asia, in the USA, also in Europe, you have select retailers. But then also our online store, Insta360.com, very welcome to check it out. We started shipping just now, so welcome to check that out.
Okay, thank you, Max.
Cool. Thank you, Nino.
And thanks, everybody, for watching. Stay tuned to Cinema 5D for more news from Photokina 2018. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks.